Hello, APU sports fans, and welcome to Cougs TV, the one show that is dedicated to covering anything and everything related to APU sports. I'm your host, Landon Troca.
And I'm Katie Richcreek.
We have an action-packed show for you today, where playoffs are the centerpiece for two teams, with one clawing for a spot and another battling it out after a first-round bye.
Other Cougar teams open their seasons with amazing home opener performances, while others close theirs off strong. We also will take a look at what an average day for an APU athlete looks like, along with a special guest from the zoo.
Yeah, we'll wrap up fall sports, head into winter sports, but right now let's jump right into football.
APU football dropped to 8th in the final set of regional rankings released last week. The team, unfortunately, was not able to climb back into the top 6 before Sunday's selection show and did not receive a playoff berth. The team did host their final game at home on Saturday. Now, our reporter Anneli Salgado with more from the game.
The team honored more than 20 graduating seniors before their final game as Cougars. These players helped the program achieve back-to-back Great Northwest Athletic Conference Championship titles and an undefeated conference schedule this season. Having dropped just one game to Humboldt State in Week 2, they later found redemption with a 55-21 win over the Lumberjacks in Week 6.
This season, to have 10 wins is pretty difficult. And then also to have beaten the team that did beat you and handily beat them, that's a big statement. So it's a statement for these seniors and this group of young men and staff. We are thrilled, but it can't be missed. Back-to-back 10-win seasons, back-to-back league champions.
Quarterback Chad Jeffries put the Cougars on the board less than 5 minutes into the first quarter with a 68-yard touchdown run. The freshman rushed for a total of 139 yards on 12 carries for the night. Running back Terrell Watson regained the national rushing lead across all divisions with his 338-yard and 5-touchdown effort. In the process, he also set the Division II football record for single half rushing yardage with 259 yards in the second half. The senior wrapped up his final season with 2,153 rushing yards, which places him in the 13th spot on Division II's all-time single-season rushing list. Watson ends his career with 21 program and 25 conference records. The defense shut down the Menlo Oaks, limiting them to only 144 yards of total offense and allowing them into the red zone just once. The Cougars added 6 turnovers on Saturday, which gave them the 9th highest turnover margin in Division II football. The Cougars intercepted Menlo quarterback Josh Neal 5 times, with junior linebacker Greg Earhart returning the third pick 48 yards for a touchdown early in the second quarter.
I feel like with the points we had this season, getting a back-to-back GNAC champs and back-to-back winning season, we're leaving a legacy. I mean, going to playoffs or not, we left a legacy here, and next year hopefully leave another legacy.
Despite not getting a playoff berth this year, the Cougars are proud of their accomplishments and hopeful for what next season will bring.
Oh, my love, my love, peace and happiness, I want to give it to Jesus.
Thanks for that report, Anneli. The team did finish ranked 19th nationally in the final AFCA Coaches Bowl, and as Anneli mentioned, they have expressed high hopes to continue their successes next year.
And although they are not returning Terrell Watson, they will be returning quarterback Chad Jeffries, as he does have 3 years of eligibility left.
And let's move into the next fall sport in the playoffs.
This past Saturday, Azusa Pacific men's soccer team lost a heartbreaker against Cal State LA by a score of 1-0. Despite being undefeated at home this season, the Cougars were unable to beat the Golden Eagles in the second round of the Division II playoffs.
The night started off with a shot on goal from Caleb Candelaria in the 56th minute, but Cal State LA goalie was up to the task and stopped the shot easily. Next, the Golden Eagles forward Andre Bismarck scored the only goal of the game in the 65th minute. Bismarck took the ball, scored, and marked his 5th goal of the season. The Cougars continued playing with an aggressive offense during the last half of the game. The Cougars had 2 opportunities to score, but both times were denied, again, by the Golden Eagles keeper.
Cal State LA will now move on to play Seattle Pacific in the 3rd round of playoffs. For the Cougars, their season ends, but it doesn't take away from the great season they did have this year. They did end up winning the PacWest Conference, and they will be returning most of their players as they are only graduating senior Jeremy Bishop.
The future certainly looks bright for the men's soccer team here. The APU women's basketball team held on to tight to beat local rival Cal Poly Pomona in a double overtime thriller. The team fought hard to stay in the game as both squads battled. Junior forward Kelly Hardiman led the Cougars to victory with 20 blocks. The junior also hit the three-point shot that sent the Cougars into the double overtime. In addition to Hardiman's leadership on the court, the rest of the team stepped up and provided a solid defensive backing to help keep the game within reach. The team is now undefeated at 3-0 after also beating Cal State LA this week. They will play Western Washington tomorrow on the road.
Well, we kind of said that we could see that they were getting a lot more free throws. They were getting to the line a little bit more, and that was because we were kind of staying outside a little bit more. So we said, hey, let's go to the basket. Let's get a little bit more aggressive offensively. And I think that helped us whether we were driving or trying to post up or do whatever, and that kind of opened our outside game up also.
On Tuesday, the Cougars faced off and won against Occidental in their fifth game of the season, two of which were non-counting exhibition games. APU came out strong and put on an offensive show from beginning to end. Senior point guard Troy Leaf scored 20 of his 24 evening points in the first half alone. Jared Zoller followed suit and found himself in double-digit points before the half as well. By the end of the night, the Cougars reached a 50% three-point shooting percentage in addition to going 59% from the field overall. APU won the game with a final score of 107-82. Here is what head coach Justin Leslie had to say following the game.
Trust and chemistry is something that's developed every day. And, you know, this team, it's a veteran group. And so they distributed the ball, you know, fairly well. We had a lot of assisted baskets tonight, which is indicative of unselfish play, which is encouraging.
The ladies volleyball team finished their season strong last week. On Wednesday, the Lady Cougs took on local rivals Cal Bapp. Despite going neck and neck, the Cougars denied the Lancers. Carried the team with 20 kills and 14 digs. And finally, on Saturday afternoon, the Cougars played their last game of the season against Point Loma. The teams fought hard, but in the end, the Sea Lions took home the win in the fifth set. Four seniors concluded their volleyball career on Friday, including Haley Beachtra, who reflects on her volleyball experience at APU.
Playing volleyball for APU has definitely had its ups and downs, but I wouldn't trade it for anything. And by far, the best part would have to be my teammates. For one, they are ridiculously attractive, but really each one of them means so much to me, and I truthfully have been so blessed to be a part of the team.
Great job, ladies, and good luck next season.
If you've attended an APU sporting event, then you are familiar with the zoo. They are the wild bunch in the front row getting the crowd hyped. Originally, the zoo was referred to as the Blackout, but out with the old and in with the new, APU seniors Jared Zoller and John Root were chosen to lead the school in this iconic transition. The zoo prides themselves on making a fun environment for both the fans and the players. The zoo is spread around campus, shining their zoo sign. Even President John Wallace threw up the zoo sign on our South Africa campus. Today, we have the honor of sitting with one of the zoo heads, John Root. Welcome, John, and thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
So let's just jump right in. You started the zoo 18 months ago. Mm-hmm. What kind of motivated you to get that started?
I think it's something I've been passionate about for a long time. I think coming here, when you go to a school like APU and you know they have good sports and you expect a big crowd and an exciting atmosphere, and I think it was something that APU was lacking for a little while, and that lacked like some organization behind it. So Community and athletics brought me and Jared in together, and we were able to start something that people just love to be a part of.
Absolutely. So what would you say your favorite moment as a member of the zoo has been so far?
I think the most memorable moment was definitely the APU-CVU men's basketball game last year. It's one of our biggest rivals now that Biola is gone. But I was thinking about a way I could really get people excited, get them hyped during the game, just something that's pretty original. So I wore a ref jersey underneath my zoo shirt, and the rally the night before, we told everybody, it was like, hey, if the ref's going to be bad, we need to do like a fake sub out. So the ref wasn't doing his job. We could say that. Everybody started chanting sub. I ripped my Zoo shirt off, started stretching behind the ref, and it was a really funny thing we were able to do, and it just like added to the fun game with a fun little element right there.
Perfect. Thank you so much for being here with us here today.
Thank you.
The acrobatics and tumbling team represent what may be considered APU's most unique athletic team. The APU acro team is one of less than 20 in the entire nation. Last year, the Cougars hosted the NCATA Championships, which invited every team in the nation to compete. After losing the championship match to the powerhouse Oregon Ducks, the Cougars are hungry for success this season. Following last season, the team lost for a season, but once again this year, they have four seniors leading the way. It will be the program's priority to try to act as a veteran team as they look to compete against the top-level schools like the University of Oregon Baylor in the upcoming months.
Have you ever wondered what a day in the life of a student athlete looks like? Well, swimmer Anna Ekberg allowed us to follow her around for the day to see what an average day is like for a swimmer.
Tired. First practice of the day. It's 5:40 and I'm about to be in a pool.
I'm not talking to you right now. You're a liar.
I have so much water in my ears and I just want an omelet. Let's go.
Some spinach. We have some bell peppers. We got some onion. No mushroom because I don't like mushroom. We got some cheese and some egg.
Just got to work, time for a long shift.
Day in life of a swimmer, and now that my day is finally over, I get to go to sleep, wake up, and do it all over again.
Thank you, Anna, for letting us take a peek at your day as a swimmer at APU.
Now we're giving you guys a special treat in highlighting the top five plays from this past week's action-packed athletic events.
Oh, we got some good ones on the way, don't we, Katie?
We sure do. We'll go ahead and start with the first one.
Yeah, volleyball here. Take a look. We got Christina Cam. Watch this. Christina Cam gets low, digs it. Then the set by Louie and Maddie Shelford just drops the hammer. It is always Shelford, so much power. Second team all league this year for the Cougars. We'll take another look at it.
And you see Jaden Louie with the assist on that. Such a very nice set. She has actually led the Cougars with assists this season. And now we have our fourth play. It's Terrell Watson running for his 31-yard touchdown, one of his five on Saturday. He finished the game with 338 yards total.
And number three here, this big shot to send the Cougars into overtime against Cal Poly. We mentioned it early in the broadcast. That's Miriam Zabinski. Take another look at that in the corner. Has to get the shot away. Such a clutch moment here late in regulation to send the Cougars on, as they did end up completing that upset.
With less than 5 minutes into the Cougars football game against Menlo, quarterback Chad Jeffries put the Cougars on the board with a 68-yard touchdown run. En route to scoring the touchdown, Jeffries shakes two consecutive defenders. Now, Jeffries actually led the Cougars second in rushing that night, and he will be returning next season.
Yeah, I got three more years of him. You know, we're losing Terrell Watson, but we got some talent coming back. I'm sure they're going to continue to utilize his legs as well as his arm. Look at this run, just so much talent.
Yeah, that's something that you touched on, Landon. Having a dual threat quarterback will definitely strengthen the offense a little bit.
And so much. Look at this. The block dunk on that end. And now we're going to see Bruce English come down, throw it down on Andrew Johnson. That poor soul just had no idea what was coming. We'll take another look at this, as this was absolutely incredible. Bruce Johnson posterizing that Occidental player. One more look at that. Look at him throw it down, the one-handed jam.
Before we go, make sure to show your school spirit and use hashtag CougsTV to be in the running for Fan of the Week.
This week, our lucky winner was Haley Underwood. She was representing APU by wearing APU apparel and cheering on the football team with her friends.
And now, as hard as it is to say goodbye, this is our show for the week.
Be sure to tune in next time to get your exclusive of any and everything dealing with APU sports. This has been Cougs TV. Have a good night.